A welcome ITC to Sri Lanka. Your Ratnadeepa has come to the resplendent island.
So, on this occasion, we are all pleased to be here at this moment when the ITC Ratnadeepa has joined the golden mile of tourism.
Here you have
the first 5-star hotel in Asia. From there, the golf face. You have another of your colleagues from India, Taj. From Singapore, we have Shangri-La. And here, the tallest of them all is ITC. And in the background is Cinnamon Life.
This represents the Sri Lankan hotel industry.
Sri Lankans have also made their brand. So there are two Sri Lankan hotels. India is the one that started tourism hotels here long ago when Oberoi came to Sri Lanka, the first city hotel. So there are two from India and one from Singapore. I don't think you can ever get an iconic site like this in any part of Asia. I have no doubt that this will become a symbol of Colombo and Colombo's tourism. So again, thank you for coming to Sri Lanka, for being the first hotel that ITC has opened outside India. Of the 10,000 rooms they had in India, they thought now they're here in Sri Lanka is the best place to come into. And I have no doubt you follow this up with the other hotel in Kathmandu. So the presence here of ITC is also commitment that you all are making to Sri Lanka, because you must remember, and I have no doubt that there be other spots in Sri Lanka that can be developed. Well, next to you, where in the next decade, as the President's House moves on to Madivela, the whole of the Republic Square, the Navy headquarters, the old jetty, and the Customs House, the GPO, all will become a part of the tourist city.
In Goa, already they have identified a number of locations for hotels in Kandy, in Nuwarelia, just to mention some of them that we have, and the new plan for tourism will indicate the locations for tourism in for hotels in Sri Lanka. And of course, I forgot, they will have to have one in Trincomalee.
The ITC hotels are welcome to be here and to become a part of the tourist system in Sri Lanka. I have no doubt that this icon will help to increase tourism into Sri Lanka, more particularly from India. Now, this is a part of the vision statement which Prime Minister Modi and I signed last year. How do we integrate our economies and bring it closer? We in India is now one of the rising giants, economic giants, and we in Sri Lanka, which is in a crucial location for logistics, and next to India, can also now join in the process. So tourism is certainly one of the items that will be coming in here. And I have no doubt that for many Indians, Sri Lanka will be the appropriate place to spend a holiday. In time to come, it will be easier for a person in Bangalore or Chennai or Hyderabad to jump into a plane and come here than go to the northern part of India. So there's no doubt people come in and go out. And I think the economic background, convertibility, the Indian rupees, all have now been laid. So this is the start. I think more than any other sector we identified, this is the one with which you can start. And as the High Commissioner mentioned, information technology is another area that we will be moving fast on. And there are many other projects that India and Sri Lanka will have here. So again, let me say thank you for being this hotel. I know why you took time, because this is more a masterpiece of art than a hotel. In between, you have squeezed the guest in and a location that is worth. And of course, the sky bridge, Ahasa, will be something unique in Sri Lanka. You see far out into the sea, you see into the Beri Lake, and I have no doubt that from some of these points, you'll be able to see Siripada.
That is for us the ideal hotel to be in. I hope this will encourage many other hotels, many other companies from other parts of the world to come and invest here. The tourism between Sri Lanka and India is age old, long, long ago, when people traveled all the way up to Buddhagaya and Indians who came to see Anuradhapura. So it's just a question of continuing it and increasing the numbers, and that's the task of Sri Lanka, to ensure that more and more people from India would come here. And we have to certainly market ourselves in India, which is the job of our tourist industry. I won't talk at length on tourism because the tourism proposals will be announced in the coming next 2 months as to what it should be, because we have identified tourism as one of the main sectors of the economy in the first round to go up to 5 million and also to target the average as we go on of $500 a night. But it doesn't mean everyone pays that. You have the luxury hotels like this, and the others who come in, especially the young people, will pay much, certainly a small amount. So again, let me thank ITC, and you are welcome to be here and to have some more hotels. You're always welcome for that. And we have no doubt that this will see lead to other hotels, groups from India also coming in here. Before I conclude my speech, I would also like to say a few words in Sinhalese. Avurudu dehakata issella metana thibune vishala udghoshanaya. Metana thibune aragalaya. Metumage karyalaya athpat karagena thibuna. Wate watakalla thibuna. Ade wenuwata tiyenne vishala hotele. ITC samagame pradhanama hotele metana tiyena Ratnadeepa. Avurudu dehakin sthavara bhavaya athi kara. Avurudu dehakin aarthiketa pana dunna. අපි දැන් එතනින් ඉදිරියට යන්නේ මෙතන තියෙන අවුලක් පහු කළා අපි ඒ වෙනුවට අලුත් ආර්ථිකයක් හදන්න ක්‍රියා කරගෙන යනවා මේ රට හැමදාම ආනායනය පදනම් කරගෙන ඉදිරියට යන්න බෑ අපි අපනායනයට යන්න උවමනයි අපනායනයට යන්න තමයි මේ සංචාරක හෝටලේ මෙතන ආරම්භ කරේ මේ ආරම්භ කළා තියෙන්නේ ප්‍රධාන හෝටලයක් මේ වටේ අපි බලනවා නම් ඇත්ත වශයෙන්ම ලංකාව කොළඹ සංචාරක නගරයක් බවට පත් කරන්න පුළුවන්. ඒ වගේම විශේෂයෙන්ම අපේ නව කර්මාන්ත දියුණු කරන්න අපේ IT ව්‍යාපාර තොරතුරු තාක්ෂණය පදනම් කරගෙන තාක්ෂණ ආර්ථිකයක් ඇති කරන්න අපේ කෘෂිකර්මය නවීකරණය කරන්න මේ රටේ වරාය ගුවන්තොටු පොළල් දියුණු කරන්න මේ රටේ ඒ වගේම අනික් සේවා අරගන්න අන්න එහෙමින් අපි ආර්ථිකයක් හදමු ඒ නිසා තමයි විශේෂයෙන්ම මෝඩි අගමැතිතුමා සමග මම ඒ අභියෝගය අරගෙන මේ රටේ ජනතාවට හොඳ අනාගතයක් දෙන්න දුප්පත්කම නැති කරලා ඉදිරියට යන්න අපි ඇති කරන්න ඕනේ එහෙනම් මේ යන ගමෙන් අපි දැන් මෙතන තියෙන හෝටලයක් කිසි දවසක ආපහු අතන තියෙන අරගලයට යන්න එපා. ඒ අභියෝගය අරගෙන මේ රටේ ජනතාවට හොඳ අනාගතයක් දෙන්න දුප්පත්කම නැති කරලා ඉදිරියට යන්න අපි ඇති කරන්න ඕනේ. එහෙනම් මේ යන ගමෙන් අපි දැන් මෙතන තියෙන හෝටලයක් කිසි දවසක ආපහු අතන තියෙන අරගලයට යන්න එපා. දුප්පත්කම නැති කරලා ඉදිරියට යන්න අපි ඇති කරන්න ඕනේ. එහෙනම් මේ යන ගමෙන් අපි දැන් මෙතන තියෙන හෝටලයක් කිසි දවසක ආපහු අතන තියෙන අරගලයට යන්න එපා. ඒ අභියෝගය අරගෙන මේ රටේ ජනතාවට හොඳ අනාගතයක් දෙන්න දුප්පත්කම නැති කරලා ඉදිරියට යන්න අපි ඇති කරන්න ඕනේ. එහෙනම් මේ යන ගමෙන් අපි දැන් මෙතන තියෙන හෝටලයක් කිසි දවසක ආපහු අතන තියෙන අරගලයට යන්න එපා.